What to Play presents the top 15 PS4 roguelike games, all arranged by PlayScore. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. At number 15, Going Under. We open our list with a different kind of style for the roguelike genre, which lets you play as an average person for once. It's set in a sprawling mega society littered with startups. As a young prodigy, climb to the top of the corpo ladder and face off against the capitalist overlords in randomly generated levels. Choose a weapon, whether it's a good old laptop or a cleaning mop. Gaming Route gave it a score of 8, saying that as a roguelike, it doesn't innovate in the genre but has a unique charm that can resonate with many millennials. A play score of 8.29. At 14, Until You Fall.
Stop this madness.
It's not every day we see roguelike titles in VR. For your PSVR needs, enjoy a stylish hack and slash where you navigate around neon-soaked environments teeming with dangerous monsters. Use your badass ninja skills and slice and dice your way to survival. Each time you fall, you rise again, alongside a few surprises. Way too many games praise the game's VR touch, which uses its strengths to the fullest and creates a satisfying gameplay loop. A play score of 8.31. At number 13, Hand of Fate 2. Slay the Spire isn't the first roguelike that mixes card and deck building mechanics. Hand of Fate's sequel pits players against a vengeful card dealer in a chaotic dungeon crawling experience. Every encounter depends on RNG, as well as your decks, so there's high replay value here. There's an immersive world here as this tabletop journey feels like a storybook told in an interactive format. It received numerous 8s and 9s on our database and a play score of 8.34.
A game truly different from the ones around. Here, we can witness a fine example. Moonlighter.
At number 12, Moonlighter. Digital Sun's very own roguelike borrows notable elements from 2007's Reseteer, taking you into a double life as a shopkeeper tending to his wares by day and a relentless dungeon-crawling warrior at night. You can power up your character by upgrading using the resources you get from your night-crawling escapades, and you make your townsfolk proud by selling the perfect goods. Some reviewers, notably WCCF Tech, gave the game a 9.2, saying it's a wonderful game that uses a delightful separation of tools to make you want to keep playing. Its strong contrast makes every run feel rewarding. It receives a play score of 8.38. At the 11th spot, Death Road to Canada. A zombie apocalypse combined with roguelike mechanics somehow sinks into your teeth, especially when it's taken in a goofy fashion. Death Road to Canada is a comical road trip where every survival attempt is met with random strangers to encounter and fun weapons to collect. It received a score of 9 from PlayStation Universe. They mentioned it's a fiendishly constructed zombie-mashing roguelike with a veritable mountain of stuff to do. It receives a play score of 8.50. At the number 10 spot, Crypt of the NecroDancer. In case you've noticed, most of these games aren't that heavy on the visuals. What they lack in presentation, they make up for their endless replayability. For a casual indie title like NecroDancer, it lures you into the deceptively addictive rhythm-based adventure. Each movement requires you to follow the beat, no matter how silly things may be. US Gamer scored it an 8, saying, "It is a brilliant, fresh spin on the roguelike genre." It's tough, sure, but that's what the genre is. Eventually, you get the hang of it. A play score of 8.57. At the 9th spot, Risk of Rain 2. Making a huge leap from 2D to full 3D, Hopu Games takes a calculated risk with this game-changing upgrade. Each run on this alien planet is as challenging as it is rewarding. Select from its wide cast of characters with unique abilities and face off against overwhelming enemies. Its success pushed it to go out of Steam's early access, leading this bad boy to a PlayStation 4 port. It received notable praise from critics, admiring its endless replay value and characters. A play score of 8.61. At the 8th spot, Nuclear Throne. Enter the radioactive wastelands in this top-down shooter from Vlambeer. Forget humanity. They're left to the dust now. and Nuclear Throne become a living mutation and fend off hordes of organic amalgamations. Collecting powerful weaponry and powering up your body by unlocking sweet mutations isn't something we don't see every day. Maybe in the next 100 years or so. Game Reactor gave it a strong 9, praising the studio, calling it their best title so far. It receives a play score of 8.63. At the 7th spot, Darkest Dungeon. Roguelikes have always been about testing patience. What Darkest Dungeon does well is in its inherent madness. It pushes your characters to the extremes in its doomed Lovecraftian halls. This is no cakewalk, as the game punishes even the most minor mistakes in its turn-based combat. IGN's Dan Stapleton gave it a 9.10, praising the game's flow, saying, "It is a punishing and awesome game of tactics, management, and pushing your luck to the breaking point. With a sequel in the works, the madness only gets worse from here." A play score of 8.68. Number 6, Enter the Gungeon. Dodge Roll's first ever game hits all the right spots when it comes to the roguelike formula. It's funny, the controls are responsive, and it rolls all the best features of the genre into one challenging bullet hell experience. Its wide selection of guns makes the endless experience worth playing again and again. Each run inside the treacherous gungeon grants you powerful weaponry that can either make or break your quest to find the gun that kills the past. With critic and gamer scores like these, it generated a play score of 8.72. And number 5, The Binding of Isaac, Rebirth. There are so many roguelike titles that can be traced from the 80s and 90s, but one of the first games that kickstarted its popularity was Edmund Macmillan's 2011 classic, The Binding of Isaac. Rebirth was the much-needed upgrade of the old gem. This remake introduced quality of life elements that made the game bearable, but still challenging enough for veteran players. The game received critical acclaim, with most critics praising its improved gameplay and morbid story. And for that, it gained a play score of 8.72. At 4th place, Rogue Legacy. The concept of life and death in a roguelike is pretty common. When permadeath is a major mechanic to it, why not introduce a story element where your offspring succeed you? Rogue Legacy's smart take on this cycle means that every time you shuffle off your mortal coil, your kids will take your place. But that also comes with a few genetic bonuses or defects. It received a perfect score from Attack of the Fanboy, calling this PlayStation 4 port as the definitive release of the game. It received a play score of 8.78. At 3rd place, Spelunky 2. A sequel that manages to stick to its roots while integrating modern gaming mechanics. This platformer feels refreshing for new and old fans. Dig deep into this alien abyss in search of treasures and be mindful of the traps in every nook and cranny. It's still insanely difficult and will test your patience, but the light at the end of the tunnel is something to look forward to. EGM Now's score of an 8 says a lot about its systems. They stated, "Spelunky 2 rests on the laurels of its predecessor, and that's not necessarily a bad thing." It has a play score of 8.81. At 2nd place, Slay the Spire. Climb to the top of this ever-changing spire and face against deadly foes with their own strengths and weaknesses. It's an ingenious and addicting blend of card game strategy and roguelike mechanics. According to We Got This Covered, who gave it a score of 4.5 out of 5. It's easily the strongest among the roguelike deck builders out there. It cemented itself as a must-have title for anyone even mildly interested in the growing genre. A play score of 8.88. And at the number one spot, Dead Cells. Of course, taking the throne in our best PlayStation 4 roguelikes is none other than Motion Twin's multi-award winning title. Dead Cells' bread and butter is the endless cycle of life and death. You are a living embodiment of immortality with a knack for slicing and dicing your enemies in a colorful barrage of pixels. It received critical acclaim, notably in its responsive and stylish combat. If you check out these scores from reputable critics, you know how it deserves a play score of 8.97.